Hey there folks, this is GreenyXI, welcoming you right back to Let's Play Shadow Huts. This is episode 10. In the last episode, we took care of all of the smuggler's boat and finally got rid of Lily, and she was obviously very happy by thanking us when we killed off her spirit and her ghost and everything. And we met, I can't pronounce his name when it's written on the screen, let alone for my mind, so... We met the big bad guy who's been cursing us with the village, with Lily, you know, things have been going wrong, and he's been to blame with it. So today we're heading off to Shanghai. Obviously it's going to be a big place, because even when we go into it, we've got different map points, only one right now, but we'll be having different map points in Shanghai as well. Huaihan. Oh dear god. Okay, let's check it out. Oh, it's nice to see the rain. I get Bermisia vibes. 15 years ago, 1889, Shanghai. Just what color. Ooh, Shushan. Stands out a bit on the backdrop. I really made a mess of this, didn't I? Oh, heck. He's dead. Of course he's not dead. What a surprise, Master Shushan. Oh, it's him. He's on the bad guys team right now. An adept of the highest rank, Fallen. You didn't really think we'd let you get away, did ya? A little fly like you, always flitting about, causing trouble for Master Decoy?
No, sir.
You know what happens to flies, old man? They get squashed. Oh, he's okay. I was pretending to be dead. Oh, nope. He wasn't pretending. You're a fine bunch, attaching yourselves to the infamous Decoy and calling him Master. If you wanted a Master, you'd been better off declaring loyalty to one of those mangy street dogs. Oh god. Scum. After that torture session, it's amazing you have any energy left to oppose the Master's teachings. Of course, a maggot like you can't really be expected to comprehend the greatness of Master Dehi. Greatness? Greatness, you say? That's a good one. That's a real side splitter. I think I'm gonna die laughing. Enough! Shut up, you maggot. Lord Wugui, let's kill him and be done with it. Still, there's one thing I do not understand. Why do you oppose the Demon's Gate invocation? Our continent is being hacked to pieces. Lacking military might, there's one path to salvation. The Demon's Gate invocation. If we can destroy Japan, we shall send a clear and firm message to the West. Do you know of any other way to maintain peace on this continent?
Well, you could just all stop fighting. That might be a good start.
I've no use for such drivel. Destroy Japan? A warning shot to the West? You're a fool.
Yeah, surely there's much better ways of doing it than killing millions of people, you know? It's just a thought.
That's not what a Demon's Gate invocation is about. Sure, like he says, it might be easy to blast Japan out of the water, but just one misstep, and it could wind up blowing the entire world into oblivion.
Shut up, as if you know.
I think he would know as an adept. Bah, I could stand here all day explaining it to you. They'll never understand. Alas, it seems our discussion has now come to an end. Allow us to aid you on your trip to hell.
Hold it right there.
Who could it be? Who are you? Is it you, his father?
It looks like him.
This ain't no show, man. Get out of here before you get hurt. Seems the streets of Shanghai are becoming considerably more dangerous than I remember them. You're Japanese, aren't you?
Let out, buddy. I can't guarantee you'll get out of this alive.
Wait, these people have nothing to do with this.
Sir,
gentlemen from Japan, please be on your way. There's no sense in you getting hurt too. He's right. It would be wise not to meddle in things that don't concern you. No good will come out of opposing us. I'm sorry, but I heard you were in league with Dihui. I simply cannot ignore you.
Is there you, his father?
I don't know. Who are you? That is of little importance to those who are about to die.
Oh, confidence.
What an amusing joke.
Alright, fool. We'll see who's about to die.
Oh, we're getting a fight and everything. Probably like a structured fight, you know, a story one. Oh, okay. We're controlling it. So we can fuse as well. Oh, a new fusion. I'm gonna try just attacking, you know.
go straight for him. Oh, it's the same sort of setup and everything as Wugui. I think he might be his father. Right, I'm going to try fuse in after this turn. Just to try it out, but I wanted to save a little bit of SP and all that. Just in case. Oh god, how did he walk so... Whoa, those arms. Not quite natural, I'm probably, you know, saying the obvious. Stretch Armstrong style. Oh, look at that. What's he got, yeah? Takes away a large amount of target's MP. Raises all allies' special attack power 5 turns. It's the same, innit? It's the same as, yeah, Yuri's ones. Except I think that only affected one person instead of everyone on the party. Let's use Revelation anyway. Get rid of the three of them. Right, I didn't get the perfect, but it was quite tough anyway because there were quite a few presses to it. Oh, I healed him. Bollocks, I've completely discarded all of the... all the attacks we did in the first place. We'll stick with physical attacks now, I think. Ah, we're done. There we go. Didn't have that much health after all. Easy times. And we got to see a new demon as well that we wouldn't have otherwise been able to see. No EXP, many items. Makes sense. Why would he need any? But what are you, a demon? Sort of. Looked like it. I've changed my mind. I will not kill you. Run back to your master and tell him this. A man has appeared who is coming for you. Until he arrives, live out your remaining days in fear. Because he's let Wugu live, now Yuri has to deal with him. You will regret those words. Cypress Hold? Is that the name of the hotel? Or whatever it is? Are you alright, old sir? Ugh, I'll be alright. Not to sound ungrateful for your help, but I don't exactly consider myself so old yet. Well, okay, he's lived another 15 years at least. I'm Xiongyun Shen, and this is Colonel Ben Hyuga. I thank you for coming to my rescue. My name is Xuxian. I'm an adept. It would appear so. Exactly what sort of person are you? The fusion technique. I heard about it a long time ago, but I never expected to see it myself. How amusing to hear that fiend call you a demon. Talk about the pot and the kettle. Yeah, it's definitely not human. Please, Xuxian, relax. Your wounds may be worse than you think. Damn. If I weren't in such a state, I'd have made short work of those bastards. Oh, ow. It's clear your injuries haven't affected that mouth of yours. No. The shop I run is just down the way. Come with us and I'll treat your wounds. Let's go. There's no need for that. I'm feeling much better already. Much better. Oh, ouch. Ha! Come, Master Xuxian. I'll carry you there. Ah, there we go. And that was how I first met the man. The next thing I knew, he was carrying me piggyback, and I could feel my face burning red. He was an incredible man, and handsome to boot, so much so that he almost had me swooning. Goodness, was he really that strong? He must have been amazing. And he had fusion powers just like... You don't think he could be Yuri's... Could be, he looked like him. I think he was from the... Yeah... You guessed it. You're not going to find too many people in this world who can wield fusion. But I just can't make up my mind to tell the kid. You know, I guess I'm too much of a coward. And then, what happened to Colonel Hyuga after that? No. Does he know? Well, it's hard to believe that was 15 years ago. Time sure does fly. The city's completely changed too. I feel like I've been left behind to grow old and decrepit. Xuxian. What are you saying? You're still plenty young. Well... It's nice of you to say that. You're a sweet girl. Will he tell Yuri? Oh, he was right in the room! You don't say a story like that! He could have been awake, you never know. Yuri sure has been sleeping for a long time. And here we are in Shanghai, and everything. Ha! He's probably sleeping off the effect of his seasickness. Everybody's got their weaknesses. Yeah. Well then, I guess maybe I'll be going out for a while. After all these years, I feel like wandering around a bit. Maybe stopping by an old friend's place? Alright. I don't expect to be out all that late. Oh. Bye, Shushen. Oh, hello, Shushen. Okay, let's have a little look around at him then. 306. Could get a voodoo doll. I'm not particularly... I want to save up and see how much we can get, and then we'll guess some at as good as we can get towards the end of the game, do you think? It might be... Might be interesting to see that anyway. Hello, Margaret. Oh, you're going out? Yeah. Thought I'd go kill some time. By the way, you haven't seen our two smuggler friends, have you? Oh, they seem to have vanished now, haven't they? They both left a little while ago. Seems like they had someone to meet. More shady business, I'd guess. But what a metropolis Shanghai is. I just went and had a look. It's nothing like Fengshan or Dalian. No, looks like a bigger place. I love big clocks, grandfather clocks and stuff in games. They add so much style. No, I'm okay. I don't need anything. I don't think. No, he's been healed up. Good. Not yet the boss, but, you know. Right, this place is huge. I do remember this now. Pilgrim staff. Oh, nice. That was a nice lucky find. Right, so 36 up to 45. 45 up to 58. That's a really good find. Hmm. For all the adventurers. Blimey. Oh shit, I didn't mean to go back in. I meant to go like to the corner past the door and have a look up in the corner, see if there was any items, but nope. Playing tag. Demon tag? No, wrong game. Boat down the port, yep, that's ours. Mm-hmm. Probably ours anyway. Heard about a right import this morning. Ah, right, the same person. Okay. I don't know where he's meant to be going, see. Mana seed? Well, okay. Can never complain about items and stuff. Oh, this is where we're meant to go. Who knew? We've been waiting for you, Lieutenant Colonel Kawashima. Ah, it's been a while, Lieutenant Sugatani. At ease, please. Ma'am, how are we doing on the package for the mainland? The special charter is ready. Well, they're here. They got him here. About that, I was thinking we might postpone it for a bit. Mm. Understood. Then I'll relay a message to the mainland. Is that acceptable? Yes, please do. Lieutenant Sukatani, how's the investigation coming along? Yes, ma'am. We've managed to get our probes rather deep inside. Okay. You can imagine Shanghai being a big place, though, couldn't you? Such a... got a big reputation and everything. Ah yes, I forgot to introduce you, Sakatani. This is Sergeant Kato. You may talk in front of him. Is that right? Then you must excuse me, Sergeant. My apologies. An agent of the investigative committee recently arrived from Tokyo. Even I was cross-examined. It seems it's you who are under investigation, ma'am. You're safe with me, but please stay alert. Oh god, she's in trouble, is she? I'm being investigated. It must be a spy sent by one of my father's political enemies. The capital is a pit of schemes. I'll be careful. Please continue with what you were saying before. Yes, Tukai, who's fighting against our Japanese army, is planning a Demon's Gate invocation. But he still needs a few more things to cast the Taoist magic needed for the invocation. A few more things? A catalyst is necessary for the main part of the ceremony, and that will be the English girl. Tukai must also banish the four gods that block the ceremony by protecting the earthly veins. It appears that all these factors must be in place to make the ceremony possible. In the past 6 months, Tihua has collected the Black Tortoise, the Blue Dragon, and the Red Phoenix. So, we saw the Black Tortoise and Blue Dragon in action. I'm guessing the same sort of thing. Red Phoenix, we haven't had anything to do with. So the only one left is the white tiger then. And where's the white tiger, do you know yet? It's in Wuhan, more precisely. It's sealed inside the temple ruins on the edge of Wuhan. Okay. Of course, Duhai knows this. Then before it falls into his hands, we must send troops to seize it. We sent forces there twice, but... However. Every last man was lost, not a single survivor. Some terribly powerful monsters have made a nest out of those temple ruins. Are these monsters protecting the white tiger? And I wonder why they picked such a troublesome spot. I don't know, but apparently Duhai isn't able to handle them either. Somewhat fishy. What is it, Lieutenant Colonel? I've just had an idea. An idea? We fight fire with fire. We defeat the monsters with a monster. Who could this monster be? What's she got planning? Pretty sure I got a... idea. Let's have a little look around. Anything here? You wanna find an item or something? Doesn't seem to... Oop. It's a poster. Kihua's Chinese fiddle performance held every day. More on that later. Lottery ticket, okay. Thought there would be some at you in the pub. So someone left behind in a pub. It's in your own view before, old man. This here's a quality bar, so don't go bothering anybody. Okay. Get out of here, old man. You bother me. The show's about to start. Bloody hell. Trouble. Sorry to bother you, but I'd like to see the proprietor. Just tell him Shushen is here. Sorry, sir. The boss isn't in. Doesn't this place belong to Mr. Shen? Shen? Can't say recall the name. Let's stop the kidding around, shall we? I'm talking about that young lady's father. Oh, if that's who you mean. Just have a seat. He should be along any minute now. He's not the owner of this place. Ha, give me a break. This place changed hands ages ago. Well, okay. Get ready. The fiddle. That's a weird fiddle.
You've grown into a beautiful young woman, Kuihua. Since I saw you last, the sound of your playing has become so much richer. So what do you think, Zhen? Why is it that the march of time, the endless rising and setting of the sun, has to be so cruel to us old folks? At any rate, Zhen, here I am, back in Shanghai. I intend to clean things up once and for all. The legacy of Huga, who passed on so long ago. Well, perhaps next time.
Very good, very good. I love the cinematics in this game, how they're scarcely used and they're not always needed, but they add a bit of style, they add a bit of ambiance. Uncle Shushen? Uncle Shushen! Hello. It's good to see you, Kuha. You've turned into a real knockout then, haven't you? Well, nobody was here to watch you though. It's good to see you. You look well. In fact, you haven't changed a bit. He doesn't seem to have. So how's your dad? How's Mr. Shen? What's the matter? Hello? Mr. Shen? What do you want now, man? Begging for coins again, huh? Fine, I'll give you some. Oh. So you're living off your daughter's scraps? Well, what a sob story that is. Shushen? That's right, Father. Uncle Shushen is back. How have you been, Mr. Shen?
You're alive, but how?
What kind of greeting is that for an old friend? 15 long years and you look like you've seen a ghost. They tell me this place has changed hands. Is it true?
Yes, it's true.
Ah, come on. What are you being so formal with me for? That's no way for the owner of this place to... Not anymore, is he? Obviously. I'm the owner of this business.
Uh-oh.
Look who it is.
You're Wugui.
Just alive. I believe that's my line, Master Shushen. I'm finally back from Kowloon, and I find myself meeting old faces. Let me welcome you properly. Master Wugui, please leave Uncle Shushen alone. He just came here to see my father, that's all. So please, please.
Master Wugui?
Why act so surprised, didn't I just tell you? I'm the proprietor of this place. Once, Shong Yun Shen here opposed Master Dihui. Now, he and his daughter are among my employees.
I can't believe it. Is this true, Shen?
What evil shits.
Yes.
How could this have...
Yeah.
What's the matter, Shushen? Shanghai's changed. Now then, to begin the welcome banquet, you remember how to play the old game, don't you?
You too.
Back in the day, this old man was the toughest guy around. Beat him and I'll reward you.
Oh.
Yeah, I'd be accepting that reward, Master Wugui. I'll take you on first, old man.
Yeah, fight time. And we just got the new staff as well.
What better time to... Oh, another lost guy. But what better time to try him out.
Yeah.
It would be nice to have more spells in the game. You do get more, don't get me wrong, but like at a faster pace. It'd be nice. Fire versus water. Yeah, didn't do much to us, did he? Ah, close. Again. He's always close. Look at him nodding his head back and forth. It's so funny. Those enemies. Yeah, didn't get much out of that. It wasn't a boss or anything, was it? That these bastards aren't human. Oh, I get it. You all do Huey's underlings then, eh? Well, in that case, if I win, I get this place as my prize.
Oh.
In any case, your attempts will prove futile. You're far too old for this. Next up, not bad Gramps, but can you hold up? Maybe it's time for a prey. Okay. Same thing again by the looks of it, so let's get our spells on the go. Got it. Maybe I'll beat him in one this time. You never know. Nah, maybe not. Oh shit. Straight in the gut. And the chops. Get him! Yay, leveled up. Level 12. Ooh, nourishing potion. He's learnt the healing move. Very good, we got two healers if we wanted to now. Amazing! Shushen, you truly are amazing. Your arts are as sharp as ever, even if you yourself haven't fared as well. Nice. You're quite finished. Enough talk, now you face me. You do remember, don't you? Your magic has no effect on me.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. So we can't use magic. That's... But at least we just learnt the healing move in time, so we got a use for our MP. Oh, God, that's a face. How about using your famous Taoist magic? I can't, you just said. That's a lot of MP, 35, and a cures paralysis. Pretty weird specific thing to do, but... Okay. Okay, we'll try it. He told us to, so... Let's go. any damage at all, or just minimized, or... Oh, it heals him. Okay. Magic won't work on me. That's what I get for doing what he told me to do. Attack them. We'll go for attacks. Oh, no. My physical attacks aren't exactly gonna do a million damage either, are they? Oh, see, it's so fast at the end, but it's hard. Oh, he's defending. Eat the stretchy arm, so creepy. Okay, let's heal up then. I'll do. Let's see how much he heals him by. It's gonna be an awkward boss, isn't it? Nice. Got it. He's defending again. What am I meant to do if he keeps defending? It's not like he's skipping a turn to defend. Oh god. One of us are gonna die. Oh. Surely that don't count as... It must be a forced loss, yeah? Yeah, okay. Shushin. I'll be alright. You magic sucking half pint slick back bastard. And I was thinking of allowing you a quick death. As usual, you have to go and say too much. I'll cut off your limbs and serve them to Duhai, and that wagging tongue of yours as well. Ah, there they are. Yeah. What are you doing, Pops? I thought you were off eating pot stickers or something. Don't tell me you're half dead. You hurt? This guy did this to you? What's the matter, kid? You sound like you're actually starting to care about me or something. Don't go that far. Some of your friends, Shushen. Poke around in other people's business and you're bound to get hurt. I'll forgive you this intrusion. Get lost. No chance. Oh, it's you. Duhai's lousy servant. I don't care if you get down on your hands and knees. I won't let you off the hook. Who are you? Why would I tell you? It doesn't matter anyway, since you're going to die right here. You really are dumb. What an amusing joke. Alright, fool. We'll see who's about to die. Come on then, proper boss fight now, I guess. Let's get rid of Wugu. He's been hanging around for a bit too long for my liking. Give him a death. Oh god, straight from the get-go. I wonder if he'll kill himself. Oh. Oh, I missed. Oh, that's getting, sir. My skill didn't work. I see, you two are protected by the darkness. Uh-huh. Any memories of this from 15 years ago, sir? Same fighting style and all that? Yeah. I don't mind finding a shop in Shanghai as well. It'd be nice. And a lottery guy too would be good. Get off. Get your grubby mitts off me. Whoop. God, that's so creepy. I can't. Yeah, perfect. I let her go for one more turn. Let's attack. Might not be the best idea in the world, but... Might save an item by doing it. Yeah, we did too! Oh my god, what were the odds? Nice, loads of EXP, loads of cash, and a weird bottle, which... I can't quite remember what it did, but we just got one of those from the pedometer stuff. Bit of dark element. Sorted. Fusion! You're a demon. I didn't fuse. I changed my mind. I'm not going to kill you anymore, so you run along to Duhai. Since I'm here, you better hide his girly magazines, because he could get killed any day now. Don't let him go again. Obviously, Yuri probably doesn't know, but things will go a bit differently next time, kid. Yeah. Are you alright, Shushan? I'll be alright. Not to sound ungrateful for your help, but couldn't you have come just a little sooner? Yeah, I think I'm deja vu.
I know.
No, what's happening? I can't believe it.
What?
What is it? Something on my face? There's no mistaking it. His eyes and his mouth. It's an absolute likeness. Like a twin. It's as if he's alive and grew to be this grand... Oh. Hey, he's crying. What should I do? Master Shushan, is he... You guess right. Kuhua Shen. Let me introduce you. The kid's name is Yuri. It's a memento from Colonel Ben Hyuga. Huh? Hehe, things are coming to light. Yes, when I was in Tonglio, your father saved my life. Ever since then, I accompanied him in his travels. We opened a shop in Shanghai because he said we should make this our base of operations. In fact, he did it out of concern for young Kuhua. Each summer, father left the village for work, then he returned just before winter began. But there was that one year, a cold winter arrived and snow was falling, but no sign of father. And instead, what came to our village was... Forget it. I heard that the colonel had a Russian wife, and that they had a young son. But I had no idea that he would be alive. My mother died. But just my luck, I had to outlive them. How can you say that? I haven't been this thrilled in my life. And how happy Shushan must be as well. Old geezer, you knew everything from square one, didn't you? But you kept quiet the whole time. Whether it's about my father or me or whoever else. Why is everyone so damn secretive? Why? Tell me, you stupid old man. Stop it, Yuri. Shushan was agonizing over it all this time. He didn't know how to tell you. So please. I was the one who killed Hyuga.
Killed my father.
Shushan.
What did you say?
Those could be your last words. I first met Hyuga 15 years ago, here in Shanghai. Hyuga was a special assassin sent to China when the Japanese army realized Dihui was up to no good. We spent much time tracking Dihui. Finally, we learned what the Demon's Gate invocation was. We hit Dihui's stronghold, the Kyuhai Tower, and finally defeated him. It was a fierce battle.
So then, the man you told me about in Dalian was...
That's right, I was talking about your father. Hyuga put his life on the line and stopped the cursed valorization.
That my father died, eh?
Yuri, please forgive Shushan. Shushan didn't want to get involved in the same fight your father got pulled into. I can fully understand Shushan's feelings. If I were him, I would have done the same thing.
Oh, ow. I know.
Yuri.
Shushan, if Dihui is trying to repeat the same mistake he attempted 15 years ago, then the next target is surely Master Zifa.
Oh. Who's that?
You're right. How could I have been so dense?
Don't shout like that all of a sudden. You want to scare me half to death?
But that temple is the holiest place in Nine Heavens Taoism. It's protected by Master Zifa himself. Even that miserable fool Dihui should know better than to mess with that place.
Master Zifa?
Yeah, he was my teacher, a mangy old goat. He's the protector of the underground temple at Wuhan. And here's the rub. The white tiger is ensconced there, one of the gods of the four directions. At first the white tiger picture was kept elsewhere, but to keep it from falling in Dihui's hands, Colonel Hyuga placed it in the care of Master Zifa. Funnily enough, that's where Kawashima wanted us to go.
Well, I think it was us.
Which means Dihui's plotted out the scheme far more carefully than before. And if that's what he'd called in Wugui for, then it's all beginning to make sense.
Alright, I'm ready to put my life on the line for this. How about you, Yuri? Do you have the guts to walk your father's path?
My father's path?
Mm-hmm. It'll be a difficult and painful road. When you arrive, you may find nothing but despair and ruin. You up to the challenge, huh?
What'd you say?
Shushan, how can you ask such a thing of him?
Butt out, kid. We've got absolutely no time to waste. This has been a race against time from the moment these bastards set their sights on Alice.
Alice said that she could find out why her father died if she fought Dihui, right?
Yes, that's right.
Pops, no matter what the cost, if I have a chance to see what my father saw, I won't have a single regret.
If that damn decoy really is going to release that Demon's Gate convocation upon us, then I'll do everything I can to make sure his little convocation is cancelled once and for all. Wasn't it invocation? Before. Good for you, kid. And you can count on this broken down old sage here to guide you through hell if need be. Oh, what's she doing? Oh, hello. What's this? Quite a big meeting, eh? Well, yeah, I guess. You were listening in again, weren't you? No, I wasn't. I just happened to overhear. Of course. How incredibly suspicious you are. I'm sure I don't like you. Now, don't get so angry. I got some news that I just couldn't wait to tell you all. I hear Decoy has sent his men to Wuhan, and that's not all. The Japanese military troops that were stationed in Shanghai have been secretly sent to Wuhan too.
What?
Hey, how is it that you know about Decoy, let alone movements of the Japanese army? We in the smuggling business can get our hands on lots of underground information. Something smells here. But if you're trying to help us, I suppose I ought to thank you. Well, and here I went to all the trouble of gathering information I thought you could use. Yui, Shushen, what shall we do? There's much time left. Pops, I'm sure it's Wugui that is headed for Wuhan. Don't you think that even for a great adept like yourself, he'll be an awfully tough opponent? Well, I suppose you're right. Shushen, we'll go with you to Wuhan. No, Sen. You and Kuhua, stay here and gather as much information as you can. We need this place to be the base of our activities again. Shushen. Wait here, and rest assured, we won't let them touch the white tiger. Yui, okay, I understand. Kikwa, let's go back to the shop. As the fourth and final one, we can't let them have it. Ah yes, before you leave Shanghai, stop by our place. Be careful, Uncle Shushen. Come back safe. Now then, we better get ready. They say stop by his place. Is that the pub? Because it's not quite his place anymore. I'm guessing it's meant to be. Have a little look round. 2 seconds. Doesn't seem to be anything here. Okay, let's see where our party is now. Because we'll be given one. So no Margaret. Party formation, okay. Must choose three... certain events force you to form a party. At other times, talk to Mayun to make changes. Who's Mayun? Pit fight, special fighting area where you can battle against Mr. Sense Monster. Just gives you prize money, is it? Mission for your 300 cash. I'm not bothered about that, honestly. Oh, I can go in here now. It was locked before because nobody was there. As they said. Ah, okay, it's these two. It's their room. Yeah, gotta prepare ourselves well. Okay, they come in with us. I guess we let them. Let me check health and stuff. Oh, wait. I'm gonna heal up. It's not exactly expensive, so why not? Right, and I'm gonna save, and I shall see you again next time. So, this has been GreenyXI. Hope you've enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you again in a bit when we check out more of Shanghai, and well, maybe we'll be able to go and explore more, but of the world. But I'm not sure how long we'll be while happening. Yeah, no. Thanks again for watching, folks. See you again in a bit.